on the outside.
Oh. Whoa, one car around. Oh, boy. And collecting a handful at the same time. Involved in it, the 64 of Rob Summers. It looks like the 63 tied up in there. Austin Pickens, there's Summers' car. And boy, Tommy, that's exactly what we were talking about, how fast they're going around here. The opportunity when something goes wrong to avoid it is really hard because you really don't have much time to react.
Yeah, I mean, the reaction time is so much faster than what they're used to because of the speed, the banking. They're just not used to it, and it's going to take a little bit for these guys to adjust. If they raced here regularly, they'd probably be much better, be less wrecks. But the reaction time from the spotter calling as a wreck to the time the guy has to get on the brakes, you're already in the wreck.
Like Calvin Carroll in the 39 tied up in it.
Yeah, it looks like he got slowed down, but the 64 ran into the back of him and got him right in the wreck.
I think that's Andy Seiss in the 70 as well.
Ooh, hard hit.
He couldn't get her to turn around quick enough, huh?
No.
She missed it all. Oh, there it is. And Summers, fortunately, able to crawl out of the car. Carroll, Lutz, Craig Lutz was the one we missed. Pickens, Summers, and Seiss all tied up in it. Five cars. And at these speeds, it's going to suffer some serious damage to those machines as well. We'll be right back once the track is cleaned up to go racing again.